Everyone is freaking out about this prediction that 47% of jobs are at a high risk of being automated in the next 8 years. These predictions are even more dramatic with news of tech giants such as Microsoft laying off over 9,000 people as it is investing more in AI. But can you trust these predictions? Are nearly half of the jobs going to be cut? And what are the implications in Germany specifically? I must say that this topic has given me a high dose of anxiety. And as someone who helps professionals navigate career transitions in Germany, I knew that I had to dig deeper. I have spent several hours reading research and separating, really, quality evidence from speculation so that you don't have to. These were peer-reviewed academic studies, government and institutional reports, as well as information regarding policies and further surveys. My key finding? Surprisingly, Germany brings many characteristics which will likely lead it to a different development as it is happening elsewhere in the world. At the same time, though, it presents some great risks. I'd say, let's dive right into it. In the year 2013, the Oxford professors Carl Benedict Fry and Michael Osborne have published an article that would reverberate greatly, not only in the academic environment, but also in politics, news, and in the several discussions for years to come. The article was titled, "The Future of Employment: How Susceptible Are Jobs to Computerization?" And it has made an occupation-based analysis of 702 occupations in the US labor market, and has analyzed their risk of computerization in the next 10 to 20 years. Summarizing, their result was that 47% of these US jobs were at a high risk of computerization. Nevertheless, this study was later extensively criticized. The key point for the critics is that it considered entire occupations to be completely automatable. But this isn't very realistic. A much more realistic scenario would be for specific tasks rather than entire occupations to be automatable. But if these 47% refer to a study that is over a decade old and has had lots of critics, what do other studies have to say in this matter? In 2016, the OECD has published a study in which they have utilized a task-related approach rather than the occupation approach, which was criticized. Their findings couldn't be more different than those of Frey and Osborne. According to this study, only 9% of jobs in the OECD were automatable. A more recent study from McKinsey from the year of 2023 states that 30% of work hours across industries could be automated by generative AI, with job transformation, not mass unemployment, as the dominant outcome. Job transformation meaning that people will need to adapt and perform new tasks. Possibly tasks that didn't even exist a couple of years ago, like prompt engineering. The range couldn't be greater between the studies. We're talking about something between 9% impact in the job market from the OECD study to 47% from the study of Fred and Osborne. Now, I know that these conflicting predictions can be quite overwhelming. And that is exactly why I spend so much time breaking down complex career impacts for my clients. But let's take a look at what this specifically means for Germany. This year, I have published a video about Germany's job market. In it, I have mentioned that over 20 million baby boomers are going into retirement until 2036, that Germany's fertility rate cannot secure a stable population, and also that Germany's employment agency estimates that around 400,000 immigrants per year are necessary to cover the demographic gap. If you have ever needed a German Amt, that is a government department, you know that it might take a while until you get an answer and your case has been processed. I am not saying that they couldn't be more efficient today, don't get me wrong, as they obviously could be way less bureaucratic. But we must acknowledge that they also are experiencing the same demographic change that companies are facing. As a matter of fact, the same federal employment agency that has estimated a need of 400,000 immigrants per year is going to lose 32,000 workers out of its 115,000 to retirement until the year of 2032. In order to cope with this challenge, they are implementing AI and further digital workflows to increase productivity, and already estimate time savings of over 30%, coincidentally confirming McKinsey's predictions. In the context of this demographic change, automations and higher productivity through AI might be what enables many German companies to remain competitive in the market. Additionally, even though news about artificial intelligence and the job market is causing lots of anxiety in the world, me included, these technologies might even be beneficial for the mental health of employees. A study from Koch and Ludefag has analyzed the impacts of artificial intelligence and worker stress in Germany. In their findings, they have stated that exposure to AI and robot technology are, quote, changing the way we perform our job in a way that is easing our work and thus making it less stressful. Now consider this. If your job gains 30% efficiency through AI, what even becomes possible? More thorough client consultations, deeper analysis, innovative problem solving, strategic planning, and all of the tasks that require human judgment, creativity, and relationship skills. This is much, much better than only performing tedious tasks that actually can be automated. Technology substituting certain tasks or even certain jobs is nothing new. As a society, we're actually quite used to it. Simply put, printing books, for instance, has made manually copying books by hand completely obsolete. All of this even before computers were a remote possibility. As time passes, new professions emerge and others get outdated with new technology. We are used to it, and we as humans have always adapted to these advancements. The challenge with artificial intelligence is that advancement is so fast-paced that it is difficult to adapt in time. And here is where the risk lays. Simplifying it, there are three scenarios for AI adoption. 1. Fast adoption. 2. Delayed implementation. And 3. Gradual adoption. If you implement AI too fast, you risk that workers do not have enough time to adapt. If you implement it too slowly, you risk that you are not competitive anymore. Nevertheless, if you adopt it gradually, you can give workers time to adapt, and even though you have some risks, you still advance technology-wise. In my opinion, Germany is clearly on a path towards gradual adoption. If everyone is currently on a run for AI adoption, what makes me think that Germany will have a rather gradual adoption than the fast automation? Well, Germany has some deceleration factors, meaning factors that make its adoption slower. Prepare yourself, because now you're going to hear some complicated sounding names. There's the European Union's Artificial Intelligence Act, the General Data Protection Regulation from the European Union too, and Germany's Works Constitution Act, Betriebsverfassungsgesetz, alongside with strong unions and works councils, Betriebsräte. The EU AI Act is a framework that categorizes AI systems into 4 different categories and created regulations to each of them. This legislation creates a deceleration factor as companies need to ensure compliance with the legislation. Since many AI systems also aim to process personal data, the GDPR also plays a big role in regulating AI systems. It is, for instance, forbidden to automatically reject candidates based on an AI system. And now, coming from the EU perspective to Germany's, we not only have the aforementioned regulations, but also strong unions and works councils. For those of you who don't know, the Works Councils are a body of employee representatives that advocates for the interests of employees within a company and that usually have very strong ties with unions. Works Councils have by law many rights within companies. And the law which regulates the workings of the Works Councils, the Germany's Works Constitution Act, Betriebsverfassungsgesetz, has been reformed in 2021. The consequence is that the Works Council has co-determination rights for AI systems that, for instance, can automate behavior or performance controls on employees. By the nature of their interests and their strong influence within German companies, it is to expect that unions and works councils will, in general, shape the adoption of AI for it to foster productivity and competitiveness, yes, but also doing everything to avoid job losses. All of these factors, the regulations from the EU AI Act, the GDPR, as well as unions and works councils, reduce the speed with which AI is going to be implemented in Germany. At the same time, there are great pressures from the demographic challenge, shortage of workers, and the world competition to counterbalance this impact, fostering the adoption of AI systems. So, in my opinion, these contradictory forces lead to a gradual adoption of AI, which will be slower than in other countries which are less regulated, but which is also going to give employees more time to adapt. In this context, one of the key questions I hear from professionals every day in consultations is, how do I future-proof my career? And honestly, this is where individual strategy becomes crucial. Here you need to reflect on what tasks and skills cannot be easily substituted by an artificial intelligence. We're not thinking about anything highly operational with lots of patterns. We're thinking about things that involve complex human relationships and social dynamics, empathy, and decision-making in some ambiguous contexts which AI can't handle very well. Besides, I think that everyone should learn how to leverage AI within their jobs. It's coming whether you want it or not. And prompt engineering, understanding agentic workflows, and designing processes within AI are skills in the future for many, many new professions. There is nonetheless one aspect that worries me the most, and that has to do with entry-level jobs. This entry-level concern is something that I'm seeing more and more frequently in career consultations. Young professionals are asking how to position themselves when traditional entry points might be changing. You have to see that many of the tasks which AI models are becoming every day more and more proficient in are performed today, especially by entry-level workforce. And it does present a great risk for entry-level openings to become more and more rare. At the same time, Gen Z and Alpha are more proficient using AI than any other generation and might be able to leverage it to their advantage. It is going to be even harder to get an entry-level position, but at the same time, the entry-level positions which people are going to be getting are going to be relying more on a deeper technical analysis, innovative problem-solving, strategic planning, all tasks that require human judgment, creativity, in relationship skills. And to be honest, I think that these tasks are way more interesting than simply writing reports or doing some research job. It is, in this context, even more important for you to position yourself so that you get the jobs that are out there. The AI revolution is here, and there's no more running from it. But here's what we've learned. Rather than the doomsday scenario of 47% job losses, we're looking at task transformation, which could actually make, sometimes, work more interesting and less stressful. Germany's regulatory approach and stronger work protections means that you have time to adapt. And AI adoption might even be the solution to cope with the great demographic challenges which Germany is facing. So, what is your next step? Start today. Learn to work with AI. And learn how to use it as a tool to leverage your own personal value. Also, identify the uniquely human value that you bring and no algorithm can replicate. If you're feeling overwhelmed about where to start or how to position yourself in this challenging and changing landscape, know that you are not alone and you don't have to figure it out alone. As a career consultant specializing in the German job market, I help professionals like you navigate exactly these kinds of transitions. Whether you're worried about your current role, looking to pivot industries, or simply want to future-proof your career, I've put together resources and consultation options to help you create a personalized strategy. You can find all the details about my career consulting services in the description below, alongside with links to the studies we've discussed today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.